Hi, I'm Geneva. I'm so glad you're here to visit the Smithsonian National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute with me today. We're here at the Milk Repository, a really special place where scientists have collected thousands of milk samples from over 100 mammals in order to better understand those mammals, the nutrients inside the milk, because it's more than just calcium that's good for your bones, the other components of milk, like hormones, and to use all of this knowledge to save species. So grab a glass and come inside with me. We're about to meet Hannah, a laboratory technician and scientist here at the Milk Repository. Before we learn more about her unZOOsual career, I'll give you three clues. One, she uses chemistry every day. Two, she works with a lot of machines, including some that cause controlled explosions. And three, she collaborates with lots of other scientists to help them reach their research goals. Let's go meet Hannah and discover more about her career.
Hi everyone, I'm Hannah Schnarl and I'm a lab technician here at Smithsonian's National Zoo and Conservation Biology Institute in the Nutrition Labs. It's my job to provide laboratory support to our clinical nutrition team, help curate the milk repository, and conduct my own research on milk nutrient composition.
Okay, Hannah, can you tell me why you put us in big fluffy coats?
Yeah, we are about to head into our milk repository, which is our big collection of frozen milks from over 200 species, and we keep them at negative 20 degrees Fahrenheit in our walk-in freezer. So you're definitely gonna need that coat, and let's head on in.
So I know mammals make milk for their babies. Can you tell me more about milk and why you study it?
Yeah, so milk is what makes mammals mammals. Female mothers will produce milk for their offspring as a source of nutrition, but also for hormones, antibodies, and things like the microbiome. But not all milk is the same between species. This is seal milk. It clearly doesn't look like your typical store-bought cow's milk. And so we have a giant collection here of over 15,000 samples from 200 mammalian species that we can use to study not only the evolution of milk and lactation, but also help develop hand-rearing formulas and milk replacers for any infant that may need to be reared by our keepers rather than his own mom. One example right here at the National Zoo was Sherman the Screaming Hairy Armadillo. Armadillo milk is really, really high in calcium. And so we needed to add way more calcium than you typically find in a commercially available hand-rearing formula for something like humans or cows or dogs.
Think about it. Why would baby armadillos need lots of calcium? Hint. This hard shell called a carapace is made of bony plates, 18 of them. Answer, calcium is a mineral required for healthy bone growth.
So what kinds of tests are you running on the milk samples?
So here in the nutrition labs, we mainly focus on our macronutrients. So fats, also called lipids, our sugars, which is the carbohydrate fraction of milk, proteins, and we can also do our minerals, which mainly consists of calcium and phosphorus, which are really important for bone growth. And then some of our other scientists around Smithsonian can also do things like the microbiome. So all of the microbes like bacteria that actually do live in milk and are essential to the infant's health and growth and development as well.
What does it mean to be a lab technician?
So being a lab technician is a lot about providing technical and lab support to our scientists and helping them address the questions that they're asking using our lab techniques. So I get to get my hands dirty with a lot of our samples here, and I'm actually the one in the lab doing the analyses, doing the chemistry, but I'm also in a unique position where I'm kind of training as a junior scientist, so I can start asking my own questions about the samples that we have here. I use a lot of chemistry and food science techniques in my work. In addition, we have a lot of machines like our AA spec here that can help us fully understand the nutrient composition of our samples. Since we're measuring very small molecules, we have to be really precise and accurate with our work. In addition, a lot of our machines and reagents can get very hot or even explosive, and so safety is very important.
So Hannah, when did you first become interested in science?
So I became interested in science at a very early age. In fourth grade, I did my school science project with my childhood dog, trying to see what food he liked the best by recording which one he went to first, how long he spent at each food, and which ones he completely finished. And I just knew I wanted to do science until I was even in college, and then I discovered the kind of science that I wanted to do, which is what I do now.
I think the most surprising thing I've learned about milk is how much more is in it than just our nutrients. Of course, the nutrients are important, and that's what I study, but we also learn a lot about the microbiome and things like hormones and antibodies. And it's really more than just a food that an infant needs to eat to grow. It's also a communication pathway between mom and offspring about tons of other things like growing and immune function and even colonizing the infant's gut with the microbes it needs later in life.
What would you say is the best part of your job?
I think one of the best parts of my job is that I have the ability to make a direct impact on an animal's health by studying the milk that potentially could go into building a hand-rearing formula that would save the life of an infant animal that's been abandoned or orphaned. Additionally, I really love studying nutrition because it's a lot like putting a puzzle together. You have to figure out what pieces go where and how they fit together.
Talk about an unZOOsual career. We were just in a walk-in freezer. I loved learning about Hannah and the amazing work that she's doing here at our milk repository. You can practice being a scientist and a lab technician just like Hannah. Remember how she got her start by studying her dog and the food that that dog liked the most? You can do the same thing. Observe the world around you, ask questions. Maybe even come up with a hypothesis, test it out. Write down your answers. Maybe what you are inspired by today will inspire your career and be a part of it in the future, just like Hannah. If you want to practice chemistry and food science, there's a lot of resources that could help you make cheese at home or in the classroom, just with simple ingredients like milk and lemon juice. Make sure to look for the components of the milk separating. Write it down in a science journal, ask more questions, and then of course go find those answers just like scientists do. I hope you loved meeting Hannah and learning about the milk repository as much as I did.